scientists have developed an insane technology that will blow your mind, and probably the minds of aliens, settled on exoplanets or their moons. Just kidding. What scientists have developed is a laser technology that could detect life on other planets. Shoot for the moon. No, we will shoot for the stars. Welcome to Lab 360. It's time to explore. This amazing new technology could detect extraterrestrial life in outer space, speeding up decades-long quest to find life on faraway moons and planets. The NASA-backed research conducted at the University of Maryland shows that the laser technology could potentially identify signs of life and analyze materials from other planets. Geologists have hailed this technology, saying that the good thing about the laser source is that anything that can be ionized can be analyzed. Meaning, if we shoot the laser beam at an ice sample, scientists would be able to characterize the composition of the ice and see biosignatures in it. And not just that, this tool has such a high mass resolution and accuracy that any molecular or chemical structures in a sample become much more identifiable. But for the technology to work successfully on board a spacecraft, it had to be shrunken down from 400 pounds to just 17 pounds. Because the orbit trap was originally built for commercial use, they were quite large and hence not feasible for use in space. After spending 8 years on building the prototype, which is significantly smaller and less resource-intensive, but still capable of cutting-edge science, the hope is that this system will detect and confirm alien life, as indicated by complex compounds. Previously, scientists have used different methods to identify life elsewhere in our galaxy, such as looking for traces of methane or detecting radio energy. As far as radio signals go, the strongest candidate ever discovered for an extraterrestrial radio signal is the WOW signal, detected in 1977. Since then, scientists have discovered several fast radio bursts, or FRBs, but none come close to be as significant as the WOW signal. However, with the discovery of several exoplanets that lie in the habitable zone of its star, physicists now know where to look for signs of life. And the new year has started with a bang for the search of Earth-like habitable exoplanets. Yes, scientists have discovered a world which is 95% the size of Earth, and it is a rocky planet. And to make the discovery sweeter, NASA says that the planet may also contain liquid water as it lies in the habitable zone of its star. But how far is the planet? That is the more important question here. And as it turns out, the planet is not that far at all. In cosmic terms, it is just a block away from us. The planet, called TOI-700d, is the fourth planet discovered in the TOI system, which is only 100 light years away. The other planets in this system have been named TOI, B, C and D, which were found in the first year of TESS's observation. The composition of planets B and D is more likely rocky, and the composition of planet C is more likely similar to that of Neptune. Scientists believe that apart from the newly discovered planet E, the planet B also might be habitable. This makes it one of the few star systems with more than one planet in its habitable zone. Interestingly, TOIE takes 28 days to orbit its star, and further studies might reveal its chemical composition, and who knows, this might be the planet with life. But if we do not find life there, don't worry, there are several candidates that could host life. Take for example, KOI-5715.01. This planet could perhaps not just replace Earth should we mess this one up, but be actually better than our blue planet. Yes, this one is a super habitable planet. But here's the catch. The planet is 3,000 light years away, and traveling to it is impossible in the next 100 or even 1,000 years unless there is a sudden vertical spike in our technology. KOI-5715.01 exists in the Goldilocks zone of its star and is 5.5 billion years old, giving life more of a chance to develop, so there's something to eat, but not so old that it still can't generate geothermal heat and lack protective geomagnetic fields. If you could land on the planet, you just might be a bit chilly and you'd weigh about 80% of your weight. And guess what? you'd be able to fly on the planet. Superhumans of a superhabitable planet. Yep, COI 57-15.01 stands out in the list of all the potential habitable planets. If we could turn Webb towards its direction and read its chemical composition, it could turn out to be a game changer. Kepler-1126b. Next in the list is another super-Earth named Kepler-1126b, orbiting the star Kepler-1126. This exoplanet orbits its star every 108.6 days. But don't get too excited, because this planet too is very far away. 2072.6 light-years away. Speculus-2c. This is one of the most habitable exoplanets ever discovered as per our studies. The planet orbits a red dwarf star that's around 100 light-years from Earth in the constellation Eridanus. Only a few details are known about Speculus-2c, beyond its size and the 8 days it takes to orbit its star. It is also tidally locked, which means it has a permanent day on one side and it is always night on the other. Despite these differences, the team estimates that it appears to be the second most habitable planet discovered so far, after TRAPPIST-1e, outside our solar system, and could still potentially have liquid water on its surface. Talking about TRAPPIST-1e, the James Webb Space Telescope has started to peer at the tantalizing planets in the star system to find life or the right conditions for it. We also have the first confirmed images of the TRAPPIST-1 system from the Superstar Telescope. The image of TRAPPIST-1 is pixelated and to the untrained eye doesn't reveal much detail, but if you look carefully, we have a photobomber here. Webb's near-infrared imager and slitless spectrograph instrument observed TRAPPIST-1 on July 18, 2022. Ultimately, this image has been compiled with observations done during a quick setup shot with the instrument to ensure the telescope was pointed and calibrated properly. At the time, it is believed one of TRAPPIST's 7 Earth-sized planets was passing in front of the star. The purported photobomber, TRAPPIST-1b, which orbits much too close to the red dwarf, might not be able to sustain life, but a glimpse at the makeup of its atmosphere would still be a huge step forward for exoplanet science. Maybe we could point orbit trap towards it and find out if it can detect biosignatures. What do you guys have to say? Drop in your comments below and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360, because together we will explore